What is Hashgraph good for? What would you use it for? What are ledgers good for? Well, what we can do with them is anywhere you want to have trust in interacting with other people. So we could do, say, a stock market, and you can trust that your bid is getting in there in the right order, that nobody else is able to cheat and get their bid to count before yours when it shouldn't be. You can trust that no one's going to steal the stock after you buy it. You can trust that when you sell a stock and I buy a stock, I will end up getting the stock and you will end up getting the money. We don't have to give both of us give our property to some third party and then have it be swapped. We want to be able to do all of those sorts of things. We want to be able to store identity information. For example, you could store something related to your driver's license in a way that the DMV could revoke it when your driver's license is revoked. And if we can do that, then you can prove to people that you have your driver's license. So these are the kinds of things that we talk about. These are the things that people talk about as use cases for distributed ledgers today. But we are talking about going far beyond that. What if we could go to stock markets and auctions that are extremely fast? What if we could go to real-time, massively multiplayer online games where every move is going into this ledger and everyone is agreeing on what's happening in real time? We can have fairness enforced by the system, not by some server run by someone we all have to trust, but where no one has to trust anyone. And so we're starting to get into a world where things are more trustworthy even without any third party that we have to trust. But we can go beyond that. The original vision that drove Hashgraph's development in the first place was for shared worlds. So here's what I envision. 20 years from now, children that are born then are going to live in a world where they just take this for granted. Anytime you want to, you just wave your hand, you can create your own shared world, your own chunk of cyberspace, your own piece of the internet, and it's shared between all of us. So how would this apply to the financial services, financial technology kind of space? How would this apply to money? Not just consumers, but what specifically are ledgers and Hashgraph and these shared worlds going to bring to the world of money? Well, first of all, they can bring a money to the world of money. They can have a cryptocurrency. It can be a money that we all trust. It has a money supply that is fixed and we all trust that it is fixed. And as for the finances themselves, the financial community itself, take something like a stock market. Right now, if you're going to use the New York Stock Exchange, you have to trust New York Stock Exchange Incorporated to run the computers in a fair way that isn't going to give an advantage to his broker over your broker. But probably I'm even okay with that. I think I probably trust New York Stock Exchange Incorporated, although maybe I'd like to not have to. Then there's dark pools, little tiny stock markets that are just run by a few banks. And there maybe you really don't. Maybe each of the banks is thinking, I don't entirely trust these other banks. Any one of these other banks to properly handle the information and not take advantage of its privileged position of having more information than anyone else.